Okay, hello. This video, I will show you how to get data from the server. There are two ways to get data. But the first way, we cannot get the data, but we can get the information, the other information. And this way is more security than the second way. So, okay, let's go. The first way, we will use the API on Loraserver. We will go this link API. Okay, I will show you how to get the JWT token security authentication. First, you need to go here. Login. Click here and it will display two lines. First, you need to set to admin, and the second is admin too. Try it out. When you click try it out, it will appear some information right here. This is the code for PHP language. Okay, and this is your JWT code. You should copy all of that. Copy and into the app. Copy and paste right here. Enter, and after that, you have to reload the bank. Okay, right now you can get the information right here, but you cannot get the data from this. Okay, I will show you. Example, I will get the device. Oh no, I can get the right this. I can get the information of this. So, right here, I will type my gateway ID. Try it out. Okay, it will display my information right here. Okay, you can get the data. And now, how can you get the data to your file? And this is the way. So this first, you have to get the JWT first. Right here, again, we will get the code again. Try it out, and notice because this code will leave just 48 hours, so you need to. Get this after 42 hours when you get data. Okay, you will copy this line, copy and go to convert to BP online. This website helps you convert the C URL to PHP code right here. You can copy and paste it to your webhost localhost. With the webhost, I use XAMPP, or you can use LAMPP on Ubuntu, but I use XAMPP on Windows. Right here. Okay, I stack it. Now I will create a file right here. Okay, right here in htdocs I will create a folder with name is IIOTT. Okay, this I will create a document. I will set name get jwt.bhb. Okay, we'll open it right here. Right here, I will copy all of this code. But you need to do it. Okay, you can run it and you can get the data. But this is a JWT, okay? JWT. but your so I have to change this IP. My Ubuntu IT IP is 34, still 34. Yes. I will open a localhost to access the file. Localhost IIOTT get JWT.php. Oh, sorry, I forgot to add a echo result. Save and again, it will display your JWT code right here. And then, when you have this code, you need to copy and paste right here when you get the other information. Okay, well, this is sample. All right, here. If you want to get I want to get right here. I want to get this information. I will type my JWT. Okay, right here. And this is my code. Okay, I will copy it. Ctrl C and paste it right here. You should copy all of this. And oh, I will create a new file, get info. Okay, paste right here. And but you have to change this if you want to access after 48 hours. And copy and paste. Okay, it's SMS the old code, because I use 48 hours. So, and the other, I need to change this 34. With this way, we just get the data from the local, because you need to change this to access the server in a router, in a one router. Okay, we change it to info. Oh my god, sorry, right here, info. I forgot to echo result. Yeah, right here. Yeah, you can get the other data, but you cannot get the data which the Arduino sent to the server, because you don't know when the Arduino sent, and you cannot put it to the queue or stack, because you cannot get the data from by this way. So if you want to get some data right here, just lesson 8 or application ID, you should read about JSON to get the data from this by point to the data you want to get. Okay, we will move to the next way, the second way. I don't use this API by the integrated right here. You should go to old IoT apps, your integration. See my device. My device less than 28 minutes ago. Afterward, I will block the Arduino after I set is create one. You should choose HTTP, because I don't know how to use this influx database. Okay, right here. You have to put HTTP. And then is your IP. My Windows IP is 20. 1234. Swap the folder I put the PHP files. IIOTK strip the file I put the code. And this I will create one. I will put it php.php. Okay, I will log it. Okay, in this code I read the data from the server, and then I put it to the temp.txt. okay, you see, I put it to the temp.txt after I receive the data from the Lora server. Open right into right here. So let's start. Strip bhb.bhb, create, but I forgot to add the temp right here. I will create temp.txt. okay, after the after the data is received, it will send to temp.txt. okay, let's start. I will plug the Arduino into my laptop. Okay, wait a little bit. Gateway. Okay, a few seconds ago. I will check application. Okay, a few seconds ago. Right here. You should go here to check the data coming. Okay, there has some data coming. So you move here to check. Oh, it doesn't put anything in this, but there are some line echo right here. So we will check the code again. Oh, right here I have to change this variables. Okay, I save it and we will wait. Okay, right here, so data has come. Yes, right here, it's coming, and it will put the data, your data, which is sent from the Arduino, and put it right here. So, but if you want to get the other, how can we get the other data? And right here, I will show you in the uplink. You see, this is your own information. This is the data set from Arduino, and this information. And if you want to take the other, you need to point to the name you want to get. Example, you want to get the device name, you need to point to device name right here. So, but the other data isn't encoded. So you need to get the get the other data, but you don't need to encode it. Like this, right here, this is decode, and you need to not decode the data, because this the other data don't need to decode. Right here, you encode this data, and you will combine it with the data right here. The first variable is the data is sent from the Arduino. The second is the application name. Okay, okay, I put this right here, and assign to combine. Then I will change the variable right here. Okay, save it, and we will check it when the data is coming. Oh, right here, the data has come. You see, if you display the first is the data, and next is application name, RTF. We will check it, application name. Okay, application name, RTF. Yes, is okay. That is the way we can get the data from the Loraserver server and post to the website. You don't need to use the localhost, but because it's have to use in a same router, so you should you should use a web host online, like 000 web host. You can use this to get to post data from this web host. It's free and online. So thank you.